Aloha, Kohala. It is 3:01 on 4/24/2024.
Woo!
You're listening to KNKRLP 96.1 FM Kohala. This is Intuitive Talk Story with Kyla Allgood and
Mikhail Anna.
And we are joyfully here today.
Yes, we are.
Yeah.
Full moon last night.
Yeah, wasn't that beautiful?
Really beautiful energy.
Of course, it's there every month, but I don't know. Sometimes it just feels more special.
Well, it was a big full moon, being on the back of all these eclipses.
Yeah.
And we've been in all these kind of openings of this weekend. Actually, was a huge another star alignment that we just came off of, and that's what that full moon kind of is on the back of, which is Andromeda, the Earth and the Sun were in alignment, and so it may still be kind of in alignment right now, or moving out of it, Central Sun and the Earth and the Sun. So what that really just means is more availability to light photons, to more particulates of light coming in.
I like the photons.
Photons of light. So that's really what is more available. And so this full moon then illuminated more of that illumination of light. Mm-hmm. And kind of, I think it was in Scorpio, but in general, what it just felt like is that it's illuminating again anything you've been purging. We talked about dumping that spiritual garbage, things that don't serve you, moving into your next chapter, next cycle. So at this point, it's like illuminating anything else that needs to be revealed, removed, renewed.
Yes. Yeah, yeah. I hear you.
Brought and into a new place.
And, you know, as you're talking purging, and I wrote without judgment.
Very important.
I've had a lot of mental chatter. It hasn't been pretty. And it's a lot of self-judgment, you know, as I listen to what I'm saying to myself. Like, what? How do I get off that loop? And I put on some music. I was driving down to Kona today, so I put on some, like, 432 hertz, one of the hertz music. So anyway, I put that on, and I just allowed myself to kind of float. I was driving, so I'm floating and driving. And I found it really helped me just to stop thinking and to look, you know, notice. We've talked about this before where, you know, it's like, oh, there's the ocean, and there's the sky, and there's the grass. And it helps me get out of whatever thinking pattern I'm in that's not they're usually not serving me, whatever the thinking pattern is. So anyway, I found that really helpful today as a practice. And as I was going through this and I'm having all these thoughts and then the thoughts subsided, I thought of you and I thought of there's nobody out there. Like, as I'm tormenting myself over A, B, C, or D, it's all my creation, this world that I'm, my reality that I'm living in. And anyway, I'll just say that without getting too specific, but.
I love that. I love it. I love it. As you know, I definitely am always saying there's nobody out there. And I love that you're saying you brought real presence to your morning and it took you out of this place where you were going into that, you know, judging the self. And we talk about that a lot because there's nothing wrong in this moment. Mm. Like, when you're right here, right now, is there anything wrong? Is there anything gonna, we said this last week, is anything gonna kill me in the next 2 minutes? Mm-hmm. If it's not, then I'm probably all right. And I can just breathe into this moment, be here, get present like you did. Mm-hmm. And then all those, you realize they're stories that you're creating in your head. They're not actually happening.
Yeah.
They're imaginings. They're possible realities. And because you're a co-creator, you are actually creating them while you're thinking them. And they feel real because you're creating them. And it's a vibration. So we don't want to be unconscious creators or create things we don't like for no reason. So it's more like you took the power back into yourself. No, I'm a conscious creator. I'm here in this moment. I take a breath. This is where I'm at. This is what's really going on. Look what's around me. Nothing's happening like that. It's not crazy. It's great. It's peaceful. I'm sitting on this rock, or I'm driving the car, or whatever you're doing, no matter where you go, all of us can use these tools anywhere to bring yourself back to the moment. It's all okay right here, right now. So if I can get first there, then I can go to, okay, and I have everything I need when I need it. So whatever it is I'm feeling judgmental about, where is that now? The next question, if we're present, then we might try to explore this so we can release the judgment further from the root, which would be, where is it coming from? And it gets to back to, am I going, I'm not good enough? I'm not worthy. I'm not doing enough. No one loves me. No one's going to love me. I'm going to be alone. Is it, I'm going to be abandoned? So we need to know, what am I running? What is fueling my judgment? Because that's where my core wound is coming from. The judgment's a program. It's a friend that hangs out with the program that runs from the core wound. So I wouldn't be judging myself if I don't have this core, I'm not good enough anyway. That's why I always mess up, because I'm never good enough. Right? See, if we do that, now I'm judging because I'm not enough. And that's always the story. Yeah. See, and I've run that a lot. So, we have to do is go, where's that I'm not enough coming from? Ooh, so maybe, and we've talked about this, it can come from this life, and our mother, father is our first clue. There's where everything starts. We can usually find it by our mother, father wounding. And again, that doesn't mean trauma. It can be simple things, little things that you just felt traumatized by as a young person, a little person, a soul that doesn't know.
It could have been you ask your mom something and she didn't answer you. And you think she's ignoring you, and you get all upset about that.
Yeah.
And that's because your little person made that story, where maybe, she just had some big thing happen and she wasn't listening to you. So, I mean, that's very kind of simplistic, but much of our issues come from. Yes, there's trauma things too, but the simple things of feeling like, oh, she ignored me, I'm not good enough, I'm not important enough,
And even the stories you were probably making up in your head were similar. You're in your adult, because we do the same thing. We start creating a whole story about why they did what, who did what, or which our little person does, our bigger person. We all do that at different stages, which is why we bring ourselves back. Oh, that's silly. Not silly in a mean way, but more of like, oh, I am supported. So then we go back to I'm enough. When we give ourselves I'm enough, wait, if I'm enough and I'm supported, now what does this feel like? It feels different if I look at the same situation from a place of being supported, feeling good enough. Now I'm not going to have the same feeling, but I have to kind of dig into that root. And there's some processes that we've talked about before, picking up your pearls, places going into meditation, working with your inner child. These are the ways some ways you can go in and find those little nuggets.
And also giving yourself empathy. I listened to Judith Orloff.
I don't.
It's a book I read years ago about being an empath, and I connected with so many things on it. It helped me. It's all about helping you to understand yourself.
Totally.
Right? Whether it's astrology or different typologies, this is about being an empath. And also understanding other people, somebody who is not an empath, and understanding how they function.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, having empathy for ourselves, it's so easy for me to be empathetic with other people, but having empathy for oneself is key. It all starts right here, because nobody's out there.
Nobody's out there. Nobody's out there. That's right. And, there is something to what you're saying about, and I have some experience with this myself, being quite empathic on my own. Mm-hmm. The empathic Christic heart really responds to the fragmented, broken heart, mm-hmm. and wants to just help that out.
What do you mean?
There is an actual geometry with empathic people, mm-hmm. with those that are deeply fragmented, that there is, it becomes an actual geometry that, like our stars, like your geometry inside you or Merkaba, we all have this geometry. So it can get drawn in to the fragmentation. It wants to heal it, and then it inverts. And then it starts to it becomes almost like a codependent type of situation,
mm-hmm.
because there's inversions at play.
Mm-hmm.
So when we take back our power and we release the fantasy that was probably part of the inversion,
mm-hmm.
we bring back our stars to ourselves in upright positions. And now you can see what it truly is without this deep enmesh of wanting to save it or help it or, you know, like mold it into something beautiful. Because the love wants all separation to come home. Nothing mm-hmm. wants the, and love does not understand separation, really. Love doesn't, the absolute love, your Christic heart doesn't really get, because it's full of life. It doesn't really understand the separated energies. It's like, no, if I just tell you five more times from over here, if I went over here, then you'll get it.
Yeah.
I know you will.
Yeah.
But separate energy doesn't get it because it's right. separated. And it literally has to be composted. And it can mm-hmm. only be composted when someone makes conscious choices to do that. Mm-hmm. So that comes back to choice and self-responsibility. We can't do it for anyone,
right.
even though we really would like to. Mm-hmm. And even though we can lead a horse to water, but we can't make him drink.
Yeah.
And we just sometimes have to know when to leave the horse at the water mm-hmm. and give thanks and praise for the journey taken.
Mm-hmm.
So there's empathic, you know, if you're an empath out there and you can relate to any of that, you know, there is a lot more to all that patterning that starts to happen. And it can go anywhere from, like, you know, we can do all sorts of different victimizer programs, Christ crucifixion programs, the empath narcissist program. There's a lot in there that happens when we we are all relationshiping, usually from wound. It's usually how we start out. Like, ooh, I mean, I've been, I mean, one of my old paradigms, I was the abusee and that was the abuser and we were so attracted.
Yeah.
And bam, there I was and I had that horrible experience.
Yeah.
But yet got some really deep things of myself through that in my mm-hmm. late 20s. You know, got some jewels of myself by wading through the depths of hell in that moment and picking up some real deep pieces. But I was consciously looking around going, why am I here? What is this attracting into my world for? Why am I in this situation? Because wherever you are, wherever I am, I'm there on my own energy. I'm here because I created it.
Right.
Somehow.
Nobody made you go with that person or do those things.
Yeah.
Right.
I'm you know, retracting yeah. these things based on my, and at the time for me, that was a whole lot of I'm not good enough.
Yeah.
A whole lot of I suck and I'm not yeah. enough and I'm not worthy. And, you know, and then I manifested someone to tell it to me out loud in front
right.
of me. And so
right.
I could really see that program, because mm-hmm. that way I got it. Like, oh, I don't want to do that. Like, that's not the way I want to go. I want right. to heal that. So I did. See, so it's like, you know, we get to see the things. The point is, get the memo, or else you just keep living the trauma.
Well, and I think that's really important. You could have not gotten the memo and heard it and made it all about the other person, make them wrong, and then just go do it again somewhere else with somebody else.
Right. Either that person did do that, actually.
Yeah.
That person did repeat that pattern.
Yeah.
And they continued to be an abuser. But
yeah.
I did not continue yeah. the pattern of being the victim in, you know, or those things. I healed those portions. I did have many other lessons to come forward that I wasn't done. I had lots more lessons.
Well, the lessons don't stop coming.
Oh, they don't stop coming. They sure don't. But if you, when you know that you're in a series of lessons, like you're in the Earth game, it's a school. Mm. It makes it different than when you're like, oh my God, it's coming out of nowhere. If you are constantly mm-hmm. surprised that life is throwing you curveballs, just change your perspective. It's a school. You're going to get curveballs every day. So
yeah.
like, okay, the lessons are coming. Dun, dun, dun. Let's get excited about the lessons. What's
yeah.
today's lesson going to be? I'm going to
yeah.
meet it with grace and ease. Ooh, I'm going to master this stuff. It's going to be good. See, it's just, how do we see it?
That's true. That's true. I was at something the other night and the whole thing didn't resonate for me. Like, my body was tight and there were all these other people around and it just was, the whole thing wasn't working for me. And I was like, you're not trapped here. You have free will. You can get up and go into another room, go outside. You care if people look at you like, why is she leaving? No, you don't care about that. So let that go and go take care of yourself. Nobody here is going to take care of you, sweetheart.
That's
you
right.
You got to do you.
And then in the first place, well, maybe why did I even make the choice to be here in the first place? What sovereignty did I give up to be in here in the situation in the first place? And maybe I won't do that anymore because I'm going to start being more true to myself.
That's,
and where I really want to be.
Right, right. That was another part of it. Yes.
For me, what I find is I encounter no less and less and less and less difficulty in my world because I'm choosing to ask source with everything I do. Like, is it in my high? For me, the question for many years is it my highest good to go? here? Is it my highest good to go here? I don't really go anywhere and without asking my inner self, like, does that feel right? Is that my highest good? Mm-hmm. So if you ask yourself first out there, then you're not going to find yourself in many uncomfortable situations because you've already checked in and it's in my highest good. It's in my highest good. It's not, I don't end up there. If it's in my highest good, there's usually, the way I play the game is there's usually something or somebody there I'm supposed to talk to, meet or connect with that has like a purpose or a meaning or a piece of information, or we're just supposed to share energy. Just you being in someone's presence, you're exchanging energy, exchanging information. So there might just be a reason why you're at that location, just to receive the mana of the place. Or maybe you meet an uncle, or maybe you meet, you know, an auntie over there, or maybe you have an experience with a child, or maybe, you know, whatever it is. Yeah. Whatever you see something like, oh my gosh, I was just thinking about that and then I saw it. So there's all sorts of things when you're paying attention, it becomes fun. Like, ooh, you're in a magical pick your own adventure book. And if you live your life like that, then it's like you're on a magical adventure because you're supposed to be going, I'm on the highest good. I took the highest path. This is the way. Let's go. We don't know, but we're going and it's going to be amazing because it's the highest good. Let's go. And then magic happens. Like I literally have super magical days all the time and have all sorts of fun experiences that are like, you know, what most people, the way they look at me like I'm crazy and I'm talking because I'm like living in a magical book. And they're like, oh, well, I just went to work and I'm tired. And I'm like, oh, sorry. It's all how you think of it.
Different reality.
You can create work and all your things you go to magically, too. Right. I'm going to put out there right now. I've been wanting this for our town. I'm going to say to all of our people out there, you create like, you know, mini choreographies. All of you guys that got stores out there across the world, if you're listening, bring back the musical to life. Let's sing and dance and vibrate through life. So like our little town down here, I see our store called Grown. I'm like, the kids, some of those kids are actually my students. Ages me a bit, but there they, I'm like, you guys could come up with some 8 counts of choreography or a little slap and dance, a little stomp. And it goes on at like noon every day. There's a whoop, whoop, da 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 da, go to get something that goes down.
Uh-huh.
And it becomes a thing. It becomes like music. Every store has got like their own little thing they do that's a musical, like
little rhythmic,
or a little melody or a song they sing or a little thing. And it's like, it creates joy for us to like connect with each other, to sing and to become more expressive with one another. People tend to walk around so in their own little like, oh, hi, I can't talk to anyone. We're more expressive in our little town, but you know, in the mainland and other places, there can be pretty in their own little bubble. But imagine if everyone lived in a musical.
I love that.
Isn't that be great?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm trying to think of the last musical I saw that was entertaining.
Saw one not too long ago that was like Jingle Jangle Jingles. It's a newer musical, which also inspired me like, oh, a newer musical. They're trying to bring they're bringing more musicals back into the movie theater world. But why not live it? I mean, don't most of you create like background music? Do you have like soundtracks playing on certain aspects of your life? I mean, I do. I have a lot of soundtracks. Like literally, you know, dun 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 dun. Who's got the Rocky one going?
There you go.
In your dream, have you had the Rocky soundtrack going when you've achieved something? You know, like things like that.
You create
moments with this energy, and it's a way to make it fun, honestly, because it is like that. It's just this fun adventure. And when you're unattached and amused to the adventure, you really get to experience the adventure. And so is it not just about the experience? I mean, we are eternal beings. So you're eternal light of God, consciousness that never ends or ceases. So be unattached. Enjoy whatever framework we're in. Like, oh, I'm in this thing right now. I get to be this character. Well, that's fun. What an exciting adventure. Let me just play it out. And enjoy the ride and be with the magic that your vessel can create, the brain you have, the astrology you have. You were talking earlier about how like astrology or types are ways to help you see things. Mm-hmm. Whatever is in your movie is directly in your movie for you. It's your own movie, like completely. So you'll even have moments later where you go, oh, I see why I learned that one thing. Like it flashes in your mind, like it'll come back up when you need it. The more you access the unified field, the more you can actually access parts of yourself from your entire timeline. And they just come up when you need them. Things you've read, things you learned. It's your computer. It's a database. Like, you have a living database of everything you've ever learned is inside of your energy and your brain. And then your high heart and your heart self connected to God gets to lead this processor and just use it to, like, create and have fun with.
And having fun is a good thing.
It is.
Yeah. And I think one of the things, as I'm thinking about this experience I had the other day, is that I don't know that I had the best attitude going into the event that I went to.
Well, that doesn't help.
So when I think back, I'm like, I was a little grumpy, you know, going into the event. So I didn't really open the energy for myself once interacting with people. And maybe also going another step, is I am pretty intuitive. So I think intuitively I knew there was going to be a component of this that was not good for me. And I didn't do that before. Like, had I looked at it all beforehand, I would have said, oh, I see, that's the issue. So I can have positive attitude about this and maybe step away from that side of it.
That's right.
And
yes.
I just didn't take the time for that because I thought I was just being grumpy and judging myself as, why are you being like that? Why don't you just go and have a good time? There's no reason to be that way. So that's a lot of talking that doesn't go anywhere. Where had I tuned in to intuitively, what's my resistance here? Maybe I would have gotten a little peace and that would have helped me so that I could have said, oh, okay, now I'll approach it this way, or I won't go at all or whatever, but I'll be clearer about what it is
that you
about
were feeling.
For me.
Yeah, because you were tuning into it, and exactly, you discarded your feelings. You made yourself like, oh, well, you shouldn't act like this.
Yeah.
You did that. You kind of shitted on yourself or like admonished yourself.
I was my
there
mother.
You go.
Yeah, she was always like, ah, come on.
Come on, get your stuff and
yeah,
go.
Yeah, let's go.
So then you can see that's the mother. So now you're getting even other. Now we know it's attached to the mother. This is
and
what
I don't
just
mean
happened.
My mother even. It's just the mother.
The mother.
That mother.
That mothering thing.
In charge.
Mm-hmm.
In charge. Come on, suck it up,
and
Sally.
And just discount your feelings, kind of
yeah.
thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so you know, right then, that's part of the thing. And had you then instead gone, whenever I feel that. So anyone out there, you're like, whenever I feel that resistance, that's actually my cue to go inside. That's my cue to you know what, I just gonna close my eyes, take a breath, and like let go of whatever's going on here. It gets back to my center, ground, connect to source, cut my cords. Mm-hmm. You'd be amazed how just cutting cords just changes your whole world. I myself am going through it's a big time. We're all going through a lot, I imagine. If you aren't, then wow. Like,
maybe somebody's not going through something. That's okay.
Well, I don't mean in a negative way, but I mean just going through change, growth,
change.
Life, movement, you know, excitement, anything. Like, you know, in general, I think life's just moving all the time.
Yeah.
There's always a lot of movement. And so in whatever form you're moving in and really, you know, just your momentum is going or you're making big changes or, you know, whatever that is. For me, I'm doing little of both. I have all of those going on. I've got some big changes, but I've also got momentum and things that are, you know, very stable in my world. But I have some other places I'm making some big changes. And I can see my own attachments to those changes. Like, you know, we get attached to the things that we want or that we thought we wanted or that we think we need or et cetera.
Or that we're used to.
Or that we're used to.
Yeah.
Familiarity.
Yeah.
So cutting cords. Mm-hmm. Immediately in your second chakra and in your heart chakra usually makes a really big difference. I myself watch them like attach and then cut, attach and then cut. Like as I'm moving through things, I see how my energy wants to like, oh, but I want to hold on to that, but no. So we have to be our own parent. We have to monitor ourselves and be like, right, where do I want to be? I want to be in alignment with my highest good, with my vision. And the more I go internal, the more I go, there's nobody out there. And I take responsibility for how I'm feeling about anything. And I sever anywhere I'm giving energy away or connecting into others or doing any of those things and just come back to the center, come back to God, come back to source, come back to the earth. Now I can get in clarity and receive what is truly in my highest good, what's really in the best and highest light for me. And in that place, you have clarity again, because now I've surrendered again to my heart. Now when you go, now you would have gone, oh, well, I'm probably not going to like ABC. You'll see it immediately. I probably won't like ABC, but D&E will be pretty fun. I could go and be a blessing and enjoy D&E.
Yeah.
You know, that could be fun. Or is ABCD going to be too much? I could probably deal with it if I just hang out over at DC&E. All right, I'll do that. And then your attitude would have changed.
Right.
You would have gone and probably been a blessing, because you wouldn't be going. And this is important when we go somewhere trying to get something. Instead, when we go already full, because now you're full, you just filled up, you just did your clearing, you just did your work, you're in your protections, you're in your light. Now I'm already good. I'm full. I'm like connected to source. I don't need anything from anybody. I just get to go have fun.
Right.
Hey, whatever you guys are doing, it's cool by me. I mean, no skin off my back. I'm just enjoying myself regardless of you. Mm-hmm. So now you just get to be yourself and have fun, because I'm full and I don't need anything. So now you cruise around not needing anything, or having an expectation, or having it like it's going to get something for me.
Right.
It has none of that. You're just, hey.
Being there.
You're just there.
Being there in the moment.
Why am I here? Well, I don't know.
Yeah.
What are you here for?
Yeah.
We don't know.
You never know.
Feels good though, don't it? Like it just becomes fun, and you let it be fun. And I often have been the character. I tend to be like the deepest and most out there person for everyone I know. I'm like, who's your deepest, most out there friend? They'll say Mikkel. So I'm always encouraging everyone to just get your fairy dust on and have some fun.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I think, you know, it's always good to look back at things and see how, kind of pick them apart for next time and for the next thing, because the next thing is here. They just keep coming. The experiences keep coming. We keep having opportunities to learn and grow. So I certainly want to keep doing that, and that's why we do this.
So I want to commend Isla on using this very, very awesome example for all of on the show here out today, because this example is, we all have these. These are like everyday things that she just explained and we just went through. So that was a real, it's a real map on how to like work through these feelings you feel like when you're starting to degrade yourself. You know, you now know, okay, that's probably going to attach to a wound. I got to look at that. Then I want to find a thread. We reviewed some things. We went through it. She saw more as we were reviewing it. She then got more information.
Yeah.
And then she saw more deep. Oh, it's actually this. And it's from my, and now I'm doing the mothering thing. So see, more came out as she sat with it. You can just be reviewing in your own mind. If you don't have, you know, someone like, we're not, you know, you're not talking to a person.
You talk to yourself.
Talk to yourself. Yeah. You're talking to yourself, having that conversation like we just did. Finding all those pieces, boiling it down, and then we can release, oh, well, I am enough. I can trust myself. She has her new mantras to give herself great fuel to get into the center. Remember, there's nobody out there the next time that comes up, and use her tools. Mm-hmm. See, and that's what we all want to do. We all want to like get the process. I learned it. Now I get to implement and take a next step forward. If we don't get the memo, we just keep repeating the same programs again and again and again. And that is the definition of insanity, right? We just keep doing the same thing over and over, expecting something different.
I feel like, yeah, and I feel it's important to know what the cues are. Like as we're talking about this, I'm thinking, if I was resistant to this experience, so instead of ignoring myself or telling myself, just get over yourself and go, had I looked at what's the resistance about? Now, don't judge the resistance. I was feeling grumpy about it. What's the grumpy about? And kindly, talk to myself kindly like I would a little six-year-old.
Oh, I just saw the judgment for you comes from value, actually. Like feeling like what I have to say is of value. It's valued, and it's like it can be held, because that's I'm not supposed to feel this way. It's not a value. It's not, that's not like, that's a silly thing to feel like, but it's not, it's a value, and it's important. And what I feel is valid. what I feel is valid.
Right.
And that it's okay that I have a feeling of not wanting to do something. It's okay for me to not want to do something. It doesn't mean I'm a bad person or that I'm not fun or that I'm not a good go with the flow kind of gal.
Right.
If I don't want to do something, it's okay to just not want to do something.
Yeah. Yeah.
That alone, because you're supposed to always get in the car and go.
Yeah.
Get it together.
Yeah.
Get your bag and go.
Just go. Go no. do it.
So it's, no, I don't want to go. I don't have to go. I don't need to go. And that's okay. I can just say no and be fact with it. I really just don't feel comfortable with it. And that's just okay.
Mm-hmm.
Period.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm okay with that. And that's no judgment on me for not being okay of wanting to go do the thing. That it just means it's not in alignment with me and that my feelings are valid. And I am valued and I can value my own feelings and trust them because they have value. So,
yeah. And I want to add to that because it reminds me of right before COVID, the February, I had this January. It was in January. I had this urgency to go to New York. I wanted to see my daughter and grandson who were, he was a little guy. And I'm like, and no one in their right mind wants to go to this part of New York in February because it's cold and icy and snowy. But I don't care. I'm not going for the weather. I just wanted to see them. And for some reason, I had to go. It was like, I have to go. I didn't understand. I didn't question it. I didn't judge myself. I just said, I have to do this. And I went. And I had a wonderful time. And I enjoyed the snow and the ice and the people and everything. And you know, a few weeks later, I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm so grateful that I listened to that, what seemed kind of strange, but I didn't overthink it and I didn't judge. I just knew what I was feeling in my body. It was emotional, but it was also intuitive. And so sometimes we don't know. I think the feelings and the intuition, they live kind of close.
So this is why, okay, yes and no. So yes and no, they don't. I mean, they can, the emotional body just can take us off track because our emotions are really strong. Back to what I just said about the cords, that's a really real thing. Like I was just looking at my own. I got emotional recently and I was like, whoa, I'm in a pipe. It was pipe on the back and the front of emotional and like insertion going on. And I was feeling quite emotional. Mm. I pulled those pipes. I immediately felt different, like instantly. Mm-hmm. And I had heartstrings. I immediately pulled them completely different. Mm-hmm. So much back to like the energetics into that, something that's kind of way out there for most people, but is that we're really being, we're plugging in back to that, plugging in, we're plugging into stuff, getting siphoned by ideas, works just like a house and a charger. It's just everything out there is going, hey, can I plug in my phone? Oh, could I use your cord and plug in my phone? Mm-hmm. Everything's doing that. So when we connect into stuff, we start feeding energy that can trick us into feeling like that's the thing. But it's not, because if you take all those cords off and you connect to source again and the earth back to that, you get into clarity. Now you're going to be coming from that place when you ask. And you also are asking, like I'm trying to teach people a lot about muscle testing or body testing or listening to yourself. Simple ways, we've talked about this a little bit on the air before too. You can put your hands on your body. Easiest way is just put your hands on your body and feel it. Like, do I feel an expansion, like a lift? Like, yes, it feels kind of like you get a little lighter. Like it kind of opens. When you feel like a no, it just drops. Like, ooh, that doesn't feel good. Ooh, I don't want to go. Your body starts to contract. You know that feeling? So you're just really listening to your own innate wisdom. Like, you know, so-and-so's birthday party. Is it a lift or a drop? Pay attention. And then trust it. See, so the way you build your intuition is by trusting it. If you're like, no, that's not real, and I forget it, I'm going anyway, even though you got to know, well, now you've just dishonored yourself. You're not trusting your own intuition. So if you're going to start building your intuition, trust it, because now you don't want to go against yourself, right? So we trust what. So For me, I am really grateful. Faith and trust has been my easiest thing. Like, I had that since I was little. So I've always like, sure, I trust. I got to go. Bye. I just go on the wind. And I'm like, whatever. I don't know. I got a backpack, which is a nice quality for me, I guess, because I'm like, yay, I love trusting. And I have always found that
trusting what?
Source. Oh. I trust God. Okay. So for me, I just listen to God's source energy. Mm-hmm. I listen to source. And sometimes it's like, it's in my highest good. And I'm like, really? No, I don't want to. Really? Really? Okay, I'll go. That's my highest good. I'll do it. Sometimes I'm kicking and screaming on the path. And other times, not anymore so much, but I used to be in my life. There was many times I was kicking and screaming. I don't want to do it, but I did anyway because I have always been on mission and I always kind of knew it. I just came in that way, feeling like I'm on the mission of Christ.
Yeah, so if you have this, let me ask you. So if you have this intuition, your connect to source is telling you yes, but maybe you, the person, is saying, I don't really want to.
That happens a lot.
How do you know the difference for people who are listening? How do you know the difference between this is really coming from a higher source and it's saying yes, and I don't feel like it right now. I don't want to.
Back to clarity of what I just shared with you. So the simplest way is to get back into a 0 point field, is to bring yourself back to clarity and to love. When you come back into love and you surrender to God, if you're not willing to surrender to God, you're going to be operating from you know, skewed energies until you do, basically. Like, you know, it's kind of like you're like, whatever, I'm going to do it myself. We do it. We all do many of those things along the way, and we fight ourselves. So until we let go and don't fight ourselves and we are like willing to go, oh, all right, I truly release this and let it go. It's about you and God's source energy, your own life force and your heart, not about anybody else. You have to humble yourself to yourself. You have to be willing to do that with yourself. And when you do that, you can feel the difference. Because if you feel angst or you feel resistance or you feel a pull for anything, honestly, if you feel a pull, you're not in zero. So you are being navigating by your emotions or by your wants and desires. And that's what's trying to get us to get navigated all the time. Look, turn on the TV. Don't you want to be sexy like me, Isla? Don't you want to smell as beautiful as the Dior girl? I mean, it's all about desire. It's all about getting you to want something. Mm-hmm. The entire game is trying to get you to want it. So if you feel but I want it and I want it now. If you want it now, you really can't have it. Because if you can't, my dad used to tell me this, if you can't wait for it, then you shouldn't, then you don't need it. Because I always wanted to have it now. Dad, I need to talk to you about it now. I need to talk about it now. I want to have it now. If you can't wait 2 more days to have that conversation with me, then you don't need it. Mm-hmm. Wow. And I'm really grateful for that one because it's the truth. If you can't wait, then you don't need it. If it's like, well, it won't be there anymore. Well, then you don't need it.
Yeah. Yeah, I just had a situation like that. Well, let's take a break because we're moving along and we'll be right back. Stay tuned.
Aloha, this is Holly Allgood, inviting you to listen to Tutu's Talk Story, the second Wednesday of each month from noon to 1 p.m. Hawaii Standard Time. You'll hear from women 55 and older with fascinating stories of their lives. Please join us here on KNKR 96.1 Kohala Radio. And again, that's the second Wednesday of each month from noon to 1 p.m. Hawaii Standard Time.
The Give and Grow Discovery School, an outdoor-based educational program for keiki ages 5 to 11, meets Fridays from 9 to 2, offering children opportunities to discover their unique gifts through nature-based practices, community service, and skill building. Focusing on social and emotional learning, through hands-on activities.
Whoa!
For more information, contact Devin Longfellow at 808-895-4257. That's 808-895-4257.
Hey, Kohala P. Love here. Just a little reminder that the Plush Lounge is now open from 7 to 10 p.m. on Friday evenings with an encore from 6 to 9 on Sunday evenings. Lift in your spirit, raise in your vibration, giving you some fun music to dance to, and some thoughtful reminders about rising in consciousness and being present in your daily life. Come play with me in the lounge. I'll see you soon, right here on KNKR LP 96.1 FM Kohala.
Won't you come to the party?
Please tune in to Pinay's Favorite Hits every Thursday from 11 to 1 with your host, Annalisa Marcon. Only here in KNKRLP 96.1 FM, Kohala. And here is our top hits, Cyclone by Baby Bash.
She moves her body like a cyclone, and she makes me want to do it all night long.
All right, we're coming back. Oh my God, it's hot over here.
It's hot.
It is, what time is it? It's 3:42 on 4/24/2024.
Breaking out of things over here because, you know, it's a beautiful day and the moon, and it's everything's coming to light as we just talk about these awesome patterns that we all get to unweave. And it's exciting. It's exciting stuff because it means freedom, and freedom and self-sovereignty is really the jam. It means we get to love one another, appreciate each other, accept and respect each other wherever we are in the game. And we don't need to be anywhere for anybody, but we can just accept exactly where we are for one another. And that's kind of what I was saying about the highest good. Sometimes I want things to be the way that I want them to be, but I have to get real about what it is. I've had to do that recently. Get real about what it is and give thanks for what it is.
What it is and what it isn't.
Exactly.
Right?
And give thanks for the journey taken and the lessons learned and the magnitude of things that I gain as a person through all the experiences you have in your journey. They enrich us and make us who we are. Again, it's the experience. We're eternal beings. Don't get stuck on one play. You know, there's many different aspects to experience, many different chapters to experience. You get to do many things. It's up to you how you want to experience your life, right? But we don't want to box ourselves in. We don't want to hold ourselves in the jails of our mind. We want to allow ourselves to have any experience that is in our highest expression. So, like, whatever blesses you and makes you feel enlivened, where you get excited and feel joy, move towards that. You know, they say follow your bliss. It's really do what feels good to you. And not in it feels really good for me to eat a million bonbons. Well, not tomorrow, so maybe not that. You know, something that makes you feel good, like, long-lasting. It's actually giving you something to feel good, and you continue feeling good. And I'm waking up daily and feeling good. Gosh, when I do that breath work every day, it really helps me. Ooh, when I meditate daily, gosh, I feel good. Right? So staying in neutrality, the zero point, we're not reaching for anything. We then own our lives, and you are co-creating every day with conscious awareness. And how exciting is that?
Yeah. And making choices from that intuitive place, not so much the emotional place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And not the head. We're living from our heart, our love, our heart. And I always say the high heart, the heart of God. You're connecting the source, zero point. That's important. This neutral third, not dualistic framework. It's a unified field. Think of it that way. The oneness where there is no judgment. There is no better than or worse than. There's no hierarchy. There simply is that which is all love, all joy, all encompassing. So in that unified field, when we come from that place in our heart, we're tapping into the highest good of all beings, not just my highest good, right? But the highest good for all.
Right. And we don't always know. we definitely don't know what's good for anybody else.
Certainly not.
So it's really important that we be true to ourselves and follow that path, because maybe we're holding somebody else back by not being true to ourselves.
Absolutely. Right? In fact, I mean, when you do your own thing, you give somebody else permission to actually speak their own heart.
Yeah.
When you speak your heart, you actually are showing someone that was afraid to maybe speak their own heart permission to do the same. Because so in that way, it's you being true to yourself is in the highest good of all. That's kind of a good example of how it's in the highest good of all. Mm-hmm. Because, well, I'm just being true to me by saying my heart. But then Isla gets to experience that in her truth. And then that gives, she's like, yeah. And then maybe that gives her a little fuel to say her truth somewhere.
We inspire each other.
Exactly. We get to reflect and inspire each other by being true to ourselves. So if I didn't be true to me and I was going to, you know, I wouldn't be sitting here having this conversation at all. And then no one would hear it.
That's true.
But there's nobody out there anyway,
there's
I guess.
Nobody out there. But for those of you who may have...
For those of you who might be hearing
who
it.
Who may have children in your life, whether they're yours or they're around you, they see you. So that's one of the things that motivated me in my 30s. Is like, how can I tell my children to be true to themselves if I'm... doing what I think I should do versus being true to myself.
Mm-hmm.
And if you sometimes for some of us, if we think of things that way, kind of bigger picture, then it's like, oh yeah, you have to be true to yourself because you're not serving anybody. You don't want to model that. You just do what you're supposed to. You do this thing and you live that way because that's the way everybody wants you to be. And that's the way you think everybody wants you to be. You don't even know if that's what they want from you, but you're not living authentically. You're not living from your higher self.
Break out. Ding, 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 ding. Yeah, break out and be yourself.
Yes.
Just be yourself. See, jingles help, songs, they help you, they make up your own, whatever. It's just, they just help you embody something. When you're like starting to go small, when you go big, like, you know, just do it to yourself, be fun, break out. Then you're like, yeah, I'm going to do the thing. Whatever it is, it helps inspire yourself. So give yourself these codes or phrases. They're about helping you remember. That's another way to get you back in the groove. You know, it's like, ooh, what am I doing? I'm going into my head. No, say a sentence. La, 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 la. I mean, it could just be that, you know, do, 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 whatever.
Right.
Get yourself scratching the disc, which is interrupting that program or thought that's starting to roll.
Mm-hmm.
Now I bring myself back to the center and I can do any of my multiple processes to help myself feel good and choose a paradigm that's going to really enliven myself.
Yeah. Yeah. And I think also when we follow our intuition on the day-to-day smaller things, when something bigger comes about in our life, it's not as difficult because now you've been practicing that. So now you can, step up and...
And that's something, in fact, tool practicing. I was talking with somebody earlier, a client, about, you know, the tools in meditation. And after session, I have people do a multitude of tools or, you know, that are daily tools to use. And the point of those is to get them so like clockwork that you use them all the time. Like these things we're sharing here, you know, cutting cords, releasing agreements. They become language you just understand in your mind and you can do it very fast. Over time with practice, right? So if you read it, you know, all these things over time, they become ingrained. Now you're no longer needing to read it. Maybe you're no longer needing to even say it as long because you might just use one word. Unity, boom, you just did like five processes. So you can do things quicker as you ingrain them into your being. It's much like dance, you know, which I have a lot of experience in and it's so much fun, but it's just the same dance steps, you know, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, put it in again and again. We always say repetition is the mother of all learning.
Yeah.
And then you wake up tomorrow and that step's easy. It becomes ingrained. You don't even think of it. Eventually you're not thinking about those things anymore. You're not thinking about the feet. Now you're thinking about the hands. Now you're thinking about the head.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever. So that's the same with everything. It's just all one giant metaphor. And so the more you repeat and put it in there, you become proficient and faster. So it's not that, and I was telling someone, it's not that you do less tools as you grow. Because someone was telling me, oh, I did all the work. I did all that stuff. And now I'm done. I'm like, wow, amazing. But for me, I'm not at all done. I do more now than I ever did before. I mean, I, in fact, it's
because
just
you become more aware of more things.
Yeah, I do way more tools, and I do like all the tools I tell everybody plus a million more. And it's not that it, but they also just get faster because now I can do things on the go. I do things very, like nobody even knows I'm doing things. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm just doing things all the time because you become more conscious and quicker. So, you know, it's interesting, but it's all about putting it in, time put in, practice, hunger, passion. You have to want to grow, you know, have a hunger to be on the path of, but if you are of a Christic heart, if you feel life in your beingness, if you feel love in your soul, then most likely you feel the soul yearning to grow and to expand on some level and to embody more love. And ultimately, that's what this journey is about. And lifting ourselves back up into the higher framework so we can live in more wholeness and unity and joy. And yay, because we, those of us choosing to ride this crystal spiral at this time, are choosing to move into the new earth paradigm, more of the Eden blueprint, you know, the paradigm of the new tomorrow, the new earth, and a place where we activate our community, our joy, our cooperation, sitting at the round table in love, respecting and honoring each person's gifts and diversities and own unique hologram, and at the same time, the unified field of all that is.
Yeah, and as you were talking, I was thinking each of the things you're talking about doing that are tools become incorporated into your day, into your experiences. They're not, you don't have to think about it. You just do it. It's just there.
Yeah, as you practice.
Yeah, as you practice. Mm-hmm. Right. It becomes, but now you have a new one that you think of and you figure out. And it made me think of prayer. Somebody said to me once, "Do you ever pray?" And I'm like,
all the time.
Kind of a lot. Like, like I'm always, yeah, I do over the course of the day, as soon as I step out of the house, actually, as soon as I open my eyes now, it's like, thank you. I'm awake. I'm alive. And I can get out of bed. Thank you. And then it's the next thing. What's the next? Drink of water. Thank you for the water. You know? And I feel like those things really help, certainly help my state of being.
Oh, absolutely. Gratitude. I'm thankful all day too. I feel the same way. I'm like all day like, oh my gosh, I'm so grateful. Oh, I think, oh my gosh, I give thanks a lot.
Even when I'm like the other night when I wasn't having the greatest experience of my life.
That's really when I give thanks.
That's, I stepped out of this space where I was feeling like suffocated. I stepped out and I'm like, I took a big breath and I'm like, oh my God, thank you.
Yeah.
Like, thank you.
You had the breath to get to. Like, I mean, thank you for this. I get
and
to give thanks
thank you,
and a breath.
I'm outside and now I can just feel this. Yes. And this feels, it made it feel even tastier because I was just in there and it didn't feel good in there. So,
Isn't it awesome? The contrast is pretty amazing in the earth realm. You know, like these contrasts of these dualistic feelings, which is what's always happening. But our gratitude takes us into the higher realms immediately because it really is so amazing just to be alive, just to be breathing and feel the sun on your face, to feel the earth under your feet. You know, for all the moments, all the lessons, and especially when I'm having a hard time, that's when I really give thanks because I really have, you know, like, thank you for the lesson.
Yes.
Thank you for this opportunity to grow, even though I'm not loving this. Thank you. I'm so grateful to grow and learn. And sometimes it feels like that.
Right. And sometimes you say it until you believe it.
Yeah, exactly. Make it till you make it sometimes.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe you don't feel like saying thank you. You do it anyway, and then you start to see the jewel, the little gems in there. And it's like, oh, yeah, thank you for that.
And then you really feel so much gratitude. I mean, like, in fact, the hardest things in my life have, in fact, they've shined me the most.
Yes.
They are, in fact, the things that have got me home. And I am grateful for these very deep and rich experiences that have honestly given me the path home to my heart, to be with Cosmic Mother, Holy Mother, Holy Father, to live in my Christic heart. So I am grateful for the rich journey of learning and depth of experiences I've had up till now in my 49 years on the planet this time around, and many other moments around the Matrix that are just, I'm grateful because I can share these experiences and help others to unpeel their wounding with all these things I've seen. I feel like I've been someone who, you know, I've gotten to travel quite a bit. And as a you know, body worker, I've gotten to go into many people's homes and lives and be part of many people's experiences, as well as travel all over the world and deeply experience magnitudes of people's lifestyles. And it's been incredibly rich and informative, and it allows a huge understanding to help realize that we're all just trying to do the same thing. All the stuff we talk about, it's the same for all of us. No matter where you come from, mm-hmm. we're all just, am I loved, am I worthy, am I mm-hmm. good enough? We're all just dealing with these same base things. And so if we distill it down to, it's not really about that thing or that thing, it's just about love and about feeling wholeness. And so no matter what culture we come from, no matter what paradigm, no matter how far you have to go to get back home, mm-hmm. it is just about this journey home and to love.
To love, to be loved, and I heard something today about feeling safe, of feeling emotionally safe, and how important it is for us to feel emotionally safe with ourselves first, of course, because nobody's out there, and also with the people that we interact with, and to be aware of that.
Well, and that's a really important, and I've had to, I hold a lot of space for a lot of people, et cetera, as a worker of sorts. But my own personal world, you know, like it's really important, and I even see a more all the time how it's so important. It's always been important to me to have like peace and like a space for myself. But I, you know, as someone who holds space a lot, I can tend to just keep holding space.
Yes.
Right? You know, and just do that, yep. like be the worker. And then I'm like, I've hit my own threshold of going, you know what? I have feelings. And I'm actually have more feelings than most people realize because I'm so empathetic. I'm such an empath, actually. And I totally feel everything. And I'm seeing and traveling these places and doing these things. Well, I'm doing that because I can feel and see, and that means I actually really care. And mm-hmm. then people think because I'm strong or I'm this, or they think, you know, I don't care. I don't have feelings. I don't think anything, or I don't feel anything. I'm like, I actually feel everything, and I have feelings too. Right. So there is that part of us, like even though when we're strong or we're spiritual or you're deep or you're a leader of something, whoever you are out there, we all have an emotional body, yes. and we all need to feel safe, mm-hmm. and we need to feel like we're important and held and valued, mm-hmm. and that our feelings are valid. And that's what was really coming up today, is that recognition through the story and the process we did was, hey, my feelings are valid. It's right. okay if I don't feel like I want to do something, or I do want to do something, or I need this or I need that for myself. I have to listen to my feelings, right? It's okay to have feelings and express to the people we love,
right,
that we need to feel safe with those feelings, that's important to be safe. And I have marveled at how in fact, one of my dear friends said, she's a mom, and she was like, you know, someone asked her, like, so do you have boundaries with your kids? She's like, oh, those people? She's like, the people that tell me that they love me are the people I have the most boundaries with, because those people are soul suckers. And I was like, that is so genius what you just said, because it's the truth. People that say I love you, like your kids, your family, the people, like, they really is where we take the most liberty to be a jerk, to be mean, to let our true colors show, to mm-hmm. we feel safe, to let it all hang out, whatever. But that's just your own wounding. And if right. we all took responsibility, that's really what's going on. It's not that, well, it's just because we're close. No, it has nothing to do with being close. You just yeah. feel safe to let your own crap come out yeah. and then spew it all over your friend because you're, you know, intimate, or you're, you know, yeah. we're married, or you're my kid, or whatever. But there's never a good reason or for us to do that. If we honor and respect each other like you do a stranger, you know, my mom and I would say, like, treat your people like a client, right?
Yeah.
Treat your family like your clients. How would you show up with your client? Would you show up like that with your husband, with your wife, with your child, with your auntie, your uncle? So thinking about how we can often take advantage of our intimate, close relationships because we perceive they won't go away. you know, and so we might.
Right, because they really love us, they'll put up with that.
They'll put up with it. Yeah. But that's not cool, nor is that fun or fair. Not,
that doesn't feel like higher vibrational thinking.
No, does that feel like, yeah. why do you even, like, what is this I love you thing anyway? Like, what? That's yes. not love. That's codependency, or that's something else. So you're weeding out. We're all weeding out these programs, right? You know, what's really driving the ship here? What's it really coming from? And where do I really want to show up and live? And why am I doing the things I do? What's driving it? And it ultimately is our feelings of feeling good, feeling in love. If you're feeling, if you feel those feelings, something's going on, listen, go inside and listen to yourself and trust that it's whatever feeling you have, be honest. The more honest we can be with ourselves, the more we get to experience the freedom we deserve.
Thank you, Mikkel. It's time to go. It's Yay. Been wonderful. And thank you all for listening. And we'll be back in a couple of weeks.
Freedom and love to all.
Yes.
Aloha.
Aloha.